Mystery has shrouded many things about the letter President Lincoln wrote to Lydia Bixby during the Civil War. Scholars have argued about the authorship of the letter, and no one has been able to account for the original letter's whereabouts. Scholars have also argued fiercely about how many of those five sons actually died on the battlefield. But no one doubts that the emotions expressed in the letter are Lincoln's. In a few short words, the letter captured Lincoln's own experience of loss, and also what we know about his deeply troubled conscience at the mounting battlefield casualties by 1864. Because of the careful work of a number of historians, we know how the news about Lydia Bixby reached the president's desk. On September 24th, 1864, William Schuyler, Adjutant General of Massachusetts, wrote a letter to Governor John Andrew, in which he included the following information. About 10 days ago, Mrs. Bixby came to my office and showed me five letters from five different company commanders, and each letter informed the poor woman of the death of one of her sons. She had five. Her last remaining son was recently killed on the Weldon Railroad. Schuyler closed his letter to Governor Andrew, exclaiming, "Mrs. Bixby is the best specimen of a true-hearted Union woman I have yet seen." Andrew then addressed himself to Secretary of War Edwin Stanton on the same day, requesting a letter from the president, taking notice of a noble mother of five dead heroes so well deserved, as he described Bixby. The Adjutant General then wrote to Mrs. Bixby, requesting the names, regiments, and circumstances of her son's deaths, so that he could then pass this information along to Stanton. Stanton, too, seems to have done some of his own fact-checking, for historians found that the Secretary of War pulled the pension application that Lydia Bixby filed on May 3, 1863, upon the death at Fredericksburg of her son Charles. Having assembled the necessary information, Lincoln then wrote the letter on November 21, 1864. With an eye to its significance, Schuyler delivered the letter to Lydia Bixby in person, but first he gave copies to Boston's newspapers. Appropriately, the papers published the letter the day after Thanksgiving. Although Schuyler was likely concerned about establishing his state's bragging rights when he published Lincoln's letter, as it turned out, the decision to give a copy of the letter to the papers was prescient. The original letter vanished along with its recipient.